إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إن أوبوك بلوغ المرام book of fasting إن شاء الله. In this lesson we start about ليلة القدر, the night of degree. That ليلة القدر it falls in the Ramadan. That night it falls in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. When we say last 10 nights, automatically people count from 21st. If you count from 21st to 30, that is 10 nights. What about if the month finish in 29? From which night you should start counting? Yeah. From 20th. 20 to 29, that's 10 nights. Yeah. And you don't know if the month is ending with 30 or 29th. So always you should start your night of degree from 20th. It's not 21st, as we used to. We see, inshallah, a hadith about this. Laylatul Qadri. In the hadith 575, وعن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما أن رجالا some of the companions من أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أروا ليلة القدر في المنام. They have seen in their dreams. They have seen in their dreams. ليلة القدر. On which night it falls? في السبع الأواخر. In the last seven nights. Last seven nights. Where do you start counting from? That's the question. Yeah. If we start, 23rd, so 24th, 25th, 26th, 27th, 28th, 29th, 30th. But if a month is 29, where do you start from? 23rd. And these seven nights means it can be in even nights, not on odd nights. People they say odd nights. And you see the people in the masjid, they come a lot, plenty of the number in odd nights and relax on the even nights. But the Laylatul Qadr can be also in even nights. Yeah. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when you have seen few companions, they saw Laylatul Qadr in the last seven nights. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam say, Ara ruyakum. I see your dreams. قد تواتعت في السبع الأواخر. Agreed in the last seven nights. So what do you do? فمن كان متحريها, whoever is in the seek of that night, فلتحرها في السبع الأواخر, he should seek it during the last seven nights. So last seven nights starting from 23rd, count from 23rd to 29th, that is seven nights. If month is 30, counting from 24th. But you don't know how the month is going to end. Is it 29th or 30th? So always start in last seven nights from 23rd. Hadith 576. وعن معاوية بن أبي سفيان رضي الله عنهما بروسيس صلى الله عليه وسلم regarding to ليلة القدر ليلة 27. It's the night of the 27th. On that time, on that year specifically, it was night 27th. It doesn't mean in every year it will be in the night 27th. But the majority of it falls in 27th. Majority of the country it falls in 27th. But it's not always 27th. رواه أبو داود والراجح وقفه وقد اختلف في تعيينها 40 قولا. ابن حجر said it has been disagreed with the scholars in 40 views in 40 views to say in which night it will be. Awradtu fi Fath al-Bari, and say he mentioned that in this book, Fath al-Bari, Sharh al-Bukhari. Yeah. So scholars disagreed which night it will be. But definitely it will be from 20th to the end of the month. One night in between 20th to end of the month. So whole year, you do ibadah, you worship easily. When it comes 19th of Ramadan, start in 20th to do more effort. To do more effort. Even as Salaf, they used to increase the number of the Quran, just Quran, they recite. For example, they recite 3 juz every day. I don't think one of us recite 3 juz every day. When it comes to Ramadan, they reach to finish in 1 week. So 4 juz something. When it comes to the last nights of Ramadan, they used to read 10 juz a night. 10 juz a night. So that means you should try to multiply your ibadah. But it doesn't mean you multiply the number of the rak'ah you are praying. It doesn't mean that way. You can't elongate, it's sooner to elongate the salah you are praying. But it doesn't mean you increase the number. That's not right. Hadith 577. وعن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت قلت يا رسول الله أرأيت تلمي إن علمت أي ليلة ليلة القدر if I have signs or feeling which night it will be the night of Qadr ما أقول فيها what I should say which dua I should recite that night. Sometimes you don't feel anything. So that means in the last 10 days, 10 nights, you should recite this dua a lot. Yeah. In your salah, out of your salah, sitting, walking, trying to do this dua as much as possible. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Quli say, Allahumma, O Allah, innaka afuun. You pardon and you forgive us. Tuhibbul afwa. And you love forgiving, Ya Allah. Fa'afu anni, O Allah, forgive me. Allah minaka afuun, tuhibbul afwa, fa'afu anni. In some narrations, they add kareemun. Allah minaka afuun, kareemun, tuhibbul afwa, that's weak. To add kareemun is weak. But you say, Allah minaka afuun, tuhibbul afwa, fa'afu anni. رواه الخمسة غير أبي داود رواه الخمسة غير أبي داود so that خمسة what we said who we should remove the seven Bukhari and Muslim all other seven they narrated except أبو داود so who narrated أحمد ترمذي نسائي ابن ماجه as the narrator. So in this, that's the hadith is in the Bulugh al-Maram. In the explanation, we go few topics or few points to clarify. Awalan, fadl, the virtue of the last 10 nights of Ramadan. If you say 10 of the Hijjah means 10 days of the Hijjah. If you say 10 of Ramadan, it means the last 10 nights of Ramadan. So the Hijjah, it means the first 10 days of the Hijjah. When it comes to Ramadan, the virtue of last 10 nights, not days here, nights. Of Ramadan. That last 10 nights, you make effort but you don't do it in the normal on your life. قال إمام النووي said في صحيح مسلم باب الاجتهاد في العشر الأواخر. We make effort, striving in the last 10 nights. We make more effort in the last 10 nights. So look the hadith he's bringing. Sahih Muslim, عن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا دخل العشر when it starts the last 10 nights أحيى الليلة he stayed awake on that night. Awake in social media, awake on your TV, awake eating, awake in عبادة, nothing else. Awake for what? For عبادة. أيقظ أهله and he wake up his family. وشد وجد المئزرة and he tightened his belt to be focus on his ibadah. That is the last night. Aisha didn't mention here, he prayed tahajjud in the Ramadan. That's a bid'ah. To pray tahajjud in the Ramadan is bid'ah. So Prophet didn't pray extra salah. He didn't pray extra salah. ثانيا بركة ليلة القدر the blessing of that night. That night is not similar to any other night. قال تعالى الله سيد سو إنا أنزلناه we reveal it or we sent it down في ليلة القدر. We sent it down the Quran, or started sending down the Quran in the night of degree. And then Allah asking us, "Uma adraka?" And what will make you know? Do you know ma laylatul qadr? Laylatul qadr, what is the laylatul qadr? Do you know that? That's the question. ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر. ليلة القدر is better than 1,000 months عبادة. The عبادة you are doing that night is better than عبادة of 1,000 months. Scholars say 1,000 months means 83 years plus. Yeah. More than 83 years. So عبادة for 83 years has been focused on that night. What ibadah is better than 1,000 months? But which one is better? We'll see, inshallah. Tanazzalul malaikatu. All angels are angels descent. They came down. Angels come down on that night. Wal ruhum, even the chief of the angels, Jibreel, comes down. Bi'idhn Rabbihim with the command and permission of Allah. من كل أمر from all degrees. That night سلامٌ peace. Here that night is peace حتى مطلع الفجر until appearance of the dawn, not appearance of the sun, sunrise. It is fajr. That night ends, it starts adhan al-maghrib and ends adhan al-fajr. That period of that night. حساب الليالي العشر. Now, want to find, if we are focusing on our ibadah, want to find that how we can calculate that last 10 nights. First of all, with alarm, a bit, is not making the unity. Every year, Middle East starts the fasting and Intercontinental start the day after. That's completely. No doubt for that. But is that right or wrong? So the night you are calculating in here, Le Tocadri, they are resting, relaxing. And now they are calculating Le Tocadri, you are relaxing. So how we can combine that? Yes. Want to talk about the issue of the moon and the appearance of the moon and how you can calculate. That's another lesson, inshallah. But now when we are in the Ramadan and the last 10 nights, how you can specify where are the last 10 months? If the month is 30 days long, the month is getting 30 days long, the last 10 nights start from 21st night. I think that's very clear. Yeah. Today, first night of Ramadan, we're expecting to get ready. But you don't know the month is ending 29th or 30th. So in here, if the month ends in 30 nights, the first night of Lailatul Qadr is 21st. And that's in here. 21st is the first night of Lailatul Qadr, 22nd is the second night of Lailatul Qadr, 23rd is the third night of Lailatul Qadr, 24th, 25th, and the 30th is the last night, which is the 10th of Lailatul Qadr. So you cover here 10 nights. Another problem here, if the month is 29th, do you know it's going to be 29th? No. Tonight's first of Ramadan, you don't know month is going to be 29th or 30th. So always you are counting as the month is 29th. That's your position. In there, first night of the Lailatul Qadr is 20th. This is where we missed. And a lot of Muslims, years and years, they miss Lailatul Qadr when it falls in 2020. That's a problem. Yeah. So 20th starting. If the Lailatul Qadr is 20th, people don't agree. They don't bother. They're waiting last 10 days. But last 10 days started from 20th. But the month is 29th. So from 20th to 29th, that's 10 nights. That's 10 nights which the Lailatul Qadr can fall in. في صحيح مسلم عن أبي نضرة عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم التمسوها سيك ليلة القدر في العشر الأواخر من رمضان the last 10 nights of Ramadan last 10 nights والتمسوها في التاسعة 9th, في السابعة 7th, في الخامسة 5th. So sometimes Hadith says once 5 left for the month. When 5 left, it can be 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Or it can be from 25th. 25th, 26, 27, 28, 29. قلت the narrator asked يا أبا سعيد أنتم أعلم بالعدد منا you are companion you know the counting of that better than us قال yes companion I'm a companion I know better than you for counting say نحن أحق بذلك منك we have right than you for this counting so explanation of the religion, companions has right more than anyone else. Companions have right more than anyone else. Yeah. You have to understand that. If a companion say something, and one of the Salaf, one scholars contradict to Alayhi Salaam. We can't compare them. Priority is understanding of the companion. So he said, I asked Abu Sa'id, Matta Sa'atu wa Sabi'atu wa Khamisa. What the Prophet mean, 9th, 7th, and 5th? قال إذا مضت 21 if 21 nights passed فالتي تليها the night after that will be 22 22nd and that's the التاسعة that's the night we should look for ليلة القدر who say that a companion so it's not odd in even it's not on odd only When we pass 21 days, 22nd night, that's Tasi'ah. Look how the Prophet ﷺ calculated. 22nd, 23rd, 24th, 25th, 26th, 27th, 28th, 29th, 30th. That means counting from, assuming the month is 29th. So فَلَتِ تَلِيهَا means 22nd and onwards. 22nd and onwards, count. That's the تَاسِعَة. فَإِذَا أَمَّتَ الثَّلَاثُ وَعِشْرُونَ If 23 days passed, فَلَتِ تَلِيهَا السَّابِعَةَ The one after is the 7th. So that means 24th, it can be لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. 24th is لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. That explanation of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, Abu al-Hadith. So 22nd can be Laylat al-Qadr, and 24th can be Laylat al-Qadr. فَإِذَا مَضَى 25 If 25 days passed, فَلَتْ لِيهَا الْخَامِسَةُ The one after that we call it 5th. And that is now 26th of the Ramadan. That can be Laylat al-Qadr. The Prophet ﷺ telling us, The Qadr can be in 22nd, in 24th, and in 26th. It's not only odd. That's explanation of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri. Stop here, inshallah. Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyihi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi. Wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsanin ila yawmiddin. Barakallahu fiikum.